Hello guys, welcome to my channel HUI Tutorials. In this video, I will explain you how you can access the standard UIA properties using a flaui. So basically, if you want to identify one automation element, we are going to pass some identification parameters to the condition factory, right? So those identification parameters are also called as properties for that automation element. So now I want to access those properties after finding an element, okay? So how we can achieve that? So for that, flaui is providing one class file. Using that, we can get the information of these properties, okay? So let me just open one application here. So I'll just try to inspect it. So for example, I have a checkbox here, okay? So I'll just inspect this checkbox. So you can see, this checkbox has some information like it has a name, it has an ID, it has a class name, control type, and some other details like it is enabled or not, it is off the screen or not. Okay. So what if I wanted to identify this element using automation ID and verify the control type? If you identify anything using automation ID, it is a simple generic automation element, right? So after identifying the automation element, I want to identify whether this is a checkbox or not. So that is my scenario. So what I can do, I can just identify the element and I can use the class which is provided by flaui to get the control type of this one. So what that will return, it will return the checkbox. Then I can just use the assert statement and I can just pass the scenario, right? So similarly, for example, this checkbox has some display value, right? Like test checkbox, this name is there. So how you can get that in display value? So here, if you see, this name is having that value. So we need to get the name value in that case, right? So now let me perform these actions, okay? So I'll just create one test method here. I'll create one method. I'll name it as test UIA properties. Okay. So now I'll just copy this code for launching the application. I'll just remove this path because this is not the path I'm trying to refer. So my application is present under this one. And my application name is this one, WPF application. So basically this is a test application that is provided by flaui guys. So I just copy paste it now. And I will try to identify the checkbox. Find first descendant. So as we know, like this checkbox is having some ID, right? So I'll use that ID to find out the checkbox. So I'll just store this into one variable. Okay. So till now we have the checkbox. So as I said earlier, if you want to perform the actions on any automation element, we need to convert that into that specific type. So if you observe there, I said like, if you want to perform the actions, okay. So here I'm not performing any actions. I'm just trying to get the properties. So in that case, I don't need to convert this generic automation element into its specific type. Okay. So let this be generic only. So from this, I want to identify whether this is a checkbox or not and the name of the checkbox. Okay. So to achieve that, write console.writeline checkbox dot. So we have these properties. So this is a property. Okay. So from this, you can get all the properties values. So for example, I want name. So I can get the name from this one. Okay. So next, if I want a control type, I can simply write control type. So let me execute this. So what I will do, I'll just close the application after executing. So my method name is test UIA properties, right? My test method name. So the execution is completed. So if you open this output, you can see the name is test checkbox. test checkbox, and the control type is checkbox. So haven't mentioned any of these details while finding the element. I have provided the ID, but now I am able to get the name and control type. So I can just use one assert statement and verify this one. Okay. So this is how we need to identify the properties of any element. So for that element, if you want to access the properties, you don't have to convert that element into its specific type. Let that element be the generic automation element and use these properties and get the properties of that element. Okay. So there is another way also for doing this one. That is, on top of directly checkbox also, you can get the name and the control type also. But some properties will not be directly available on top of automation element. So in that case, you can use the properties class to get those values, right? So it's just kind of advisable, like always use the properties class to get the properties. So even while going through the code, you will simply understand, okay, I'm trying to get the name of this from properties like that. Okay. So this is how we need to access the properties, guys. If you have any doubts, please let me know in the comment section below. Thank you for watching. Bye bye.
I hope you enjoy this session. If you like this video, please hit the like button and also share it with your friends. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.